Welcome to Elmo's World! Oh, Elmo's so happy to see you. Oh, and so is Dorothy. Say hello, Dorothy. Oh, guess what Elmo's thinking about today? They like it cold.
Himself.
Mr. Noodle, be like a penguin.
Mr. Noodle, you're being a chicken.
That's not a penguin.
It's a bird, but it's not a penguin.
Think penguin. You know, like how a penguin walks.
It waddles when it walks.
Yeah, it's white in front and black in back, and it looks like it's wearing a tuxedo! A tuxedo!
Where is he going?
Mr. Noodle, he's in a tuxedo.
Flippers!
By George, he's got it!
Now that's being a penguin.
Great pretending!
Now he's got it.
Oh, more penguins.
He even fooled the penguins.
Mr. Noodle.
Waddle, waddle, waddle. He knows how to be a penguin.
Oh, that Mr. Noodle. He could get a job as a penguin. Was that Dorothy? Oh, Dorothy wants to ask someone else. How do you pretend to be a penguin?
Here's how I pretend I'm a penguin, Dorothy. I hold my arms out like flippers. I take little steps and go side to side.
Hi, Dorothy. We can pretend to be three penguins. Swimmers.
Oh, thanks, everybody. Oh, and thanks, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask a baby. Here's how Elmo pretends to be a penguin. Waddle, 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 waddle. Hello, baby. Hello. Baby, how do you pretend to be a penguin? Go ahead. Oh, thank you, baby. Kiss, 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 kiss. Sliding on ice. Let's count them and see. Oh, penguins! There you are.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Oh, 10 penguins! And 1 sea lion! It bowled them over! Oh, great counting, everybody! Penguins sliding on ice. That makes Elmo wonder, how do they stay warm? Oh, let's find out, okay? Oh, Troy! How do penguins stay warm? Oh, everybody's a penguin today! Do penguins wear long underwear to stay warm?
No, that's silly.
Do they wear an overcoat?
No, they swim. They can't swim in an overcoat.
Do they wear anything?
No, they wear nothing. They have feathers. Their feathers keep them warm even when they swim.
Does a penguin wear a muffler?
No!
Except if he's Big Bird's cousin.
This is my cousin Blubba. My granny bird knitted him a nice warm muffler. Because he lives at the pole.
Hi, y'all.
The South Pole.
Y'all got a catfish.
Thanks, Troy. And now, speaking of
Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail.
Elmo has email.
Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail.
Computer, come back.
Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail.
Computer's a penguin today, too.
Elmo has mail.
And Mouse. Okay, calm down, Mouse. Thank you. Oh, yay! Elmo has some email from Grover with some penguins. Surprise!
Hi, Elmo. It is I, your frozen friend Grover, at the South Pole for the famous moment when once a year the penguins fly back to Capistrano.
We'd like to help you, pal, but we can't fly there.
Why not?
Because penguins don't fly.
What? You do not fly? How can that be? You are birds. You have wingy things.
They're flippers.
For swimming.
We swim.
Yeah, we don't fly.
Well, of course you do not fly. You are flipping all wrong! Yeah, you have to flip up and down like this, like the birthdays you are. Come on, come on, flip with me now. Come on! Think Capistrano.
Capistrano. Capistrano.
Capistrano.
Capistrano. Capistrano. Capistrano. Capistrano.
I will settle for Cucamonga.
Cucamonga! Cucamonga! I'm flapping for Cucamonga!
What? No liftoff?
That's what we told you, pal. Penguins don't fly.
So, Elmo, correction. Today, the penguins will not fly back to Capistrano.
Hey, what? We could swim to Capistrano.
Ooh, we could, yeah.
Whoa!
They will swim back to Capistrano. So long, Elmo. Any swallows around here?
Oh, thanks, computer. Elmo's friend John just loves penguins, so his dad took him to the zoo to see real live ones. And he told Elmo all about it.
My dad works at Atlantis Marine World Aquarium. He takes care of the penguins there. And sometimes I go along to help. They live in a special place. They have a big pool to swim in, and there are cubby holes to nest in. Penguins are birds, and they lay eggs like other birds. They have a beach area to walk around in. and there's a neat tunnel that goes under the beach area and comes up under a glass dome so people can go in and watch the penguins right up close. Penguins walk standing up like people. They take short steps. It's called waddling. They even sleep standing up. They clean themselves with their beaks. It's called preening. We wash down the beach area to keep it clean. And we feed them. Fish. They really come quickly when they know it's lunchtime. They love fish. They can swallow a whole fish. Awesome. But you have to be careful, because they have sharp beaks. And after lunch, they like to go swimming. And can they swim? They like to do things together. They are outstanding.
Yeah, Elmo likes penguins too. Elmo wants to know even more about them, don't you? How can we find out even more? Oh, it's TV! Yeah, we can watch the Penguin Channel! Turn yourself on, TV. Thank you.
It's the Penguin Channel!
All penguins, all the time. That was Flipper on Ice. And what'll be next? Bubbles Martin with Penguins on Parade.
There are 17 different kinds of penguins, and they don't all live at the South Pole, but every one is a beaut. So let's see some penguins on parade. Here come the penguins, those wonderful birds. Look at them waddle, too graceful for words. Here's Apu. He's a macaroni penguin from the Indian Ocean. Namaste, Apu. A rockhopper penguin, Mitt. He lives a short hop from the South Pole. Rock hop on! And here's the littlest penguin there is, a fairy penguin. It's Tinkerbell from Australia.
Good day.
Last, Galapagos penguins live in the hottest place in the world, the equator. Hola, Jennifer. When you're hot, you're hot. And when they jump in the water, it's easy to see. They're everything a penguin, everything a penguin, everything a penguin should be. There's no business like snow business.
Stay tuned for Splash, The Wet Thing, and Good Morning Antarctica.
Thanks, TV. Boy, how can we find out more about penguins? Hello.
Why don't you ask an emperor penguin? We're the biggest of all penguins.
Ah.
You may call me Caesar.
Hail Caesar!
An emperor penguin.
Since you ask, I will tell you about myself. This is my imperial beak.
Caesar's beak!
I use it to eat fishes.
Oh.
And go.
Caesar's!
And here are my handsome webbed feet.
Caesar's feet!
And these are my fabulous flippers.
Caesar's flippers!
I use them for swimming. We penguins spend most of our lives swimming.
Most of our lives swimming!
Stop now! Oh, look. Dorothy's imagining Elmo as a penguin going swimming.
Thank you.
make quite a splash as a penguin, lad.
Quite a splash!
Yay! Elmo loves penguins, so does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the penguin song!
Oh,
I
concur.
I did a warm-up.
Oh, it's
okay.
My favorite.
Just go with it.
Yeah. Okay, okay, we'll sing along with Elmo.
Oh, catchy.
Do-do-do-do-do. Penguin, 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 penguin. Everybody sing! Penguin, 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 penguin. Penguin, 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 penguin. Penguin, 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 penguin. Say goodbye, Dorothy. Say goodbye, penguins.
I'm just passing by. I'm on my way to the doctor for a checkup.
Okay.
See you later.
Bye, Big Bird.
Bye.
That's what I'm most thinking about today. Doctors. Oh, is there a doctor in the house?
Did someone call a doctor, sir? What do you want?
Hey, I don't know.
You know, doctors. Wait a minute. That's not a doctor. That's a doctor. And a quack.
What does a doctor do with it? Look at that! He's got a doctor's coat on. Nice!
Mr. Dr. Noodle!
Wait, what's that in his pocket?
Oh, look! That's a stethoscope!
Now he's got it! A stethoscope! So do your thing, Mr. Noodle. Yeah, what does a doctor do with it? What's that?
Oh.
A dog? What's he gonna do with that dog? What's he up to? That's not where it goes. No, you use a leash to walk a dog, not a stethoscope.
Mr. Noodle, you don't put it on the dog. You put it on you.
Yeah, put the stethoscope on you. Yeah, I have a dog like that.
That's nice, Mr. Noodle.
Oops. He's okay.
Go ahead. Put the stethoscope on, Mr. Noodle.
Wait, now what's he doing? It's not a tail, Mr. Noodle.
The stethoscope goes in your ears, Mr. Noodle.
Put it in your ears.
Yeah, your ears.
Right, up there. Your ears. Good job. Now he's got it.
The stethoscope helps you hear better.
Ooh, be careful. The doctor uses it to listen to the heart.
Whose heart are you going to listen to, Mr. Noodle? So find somebody.
Mr. Noodle's looking around.
Will he find someone?
He's on the move.
Oh, Mr. Noodle can listen to Elmo's heart. Go ahead, Mr. Noodle.
No, not there.
No, that's not where Elmo's heart is. It's here, in Elmo's chest. Go ahead, Mr. Noodle.
Right there.
Oh, that's cold.
Oh, he's warming it up. Nice, Mr. Noodle.
Better.
Good job, Mr. Noodle. Sounds good.
Oh, yay! You did it! Way to go, Mr. Noodle!
Now what?
Oh, yeah! Listen to your own heart.
He found his heartbeat.
Wow! Mr. Noodle's heart is beating with a rhythm.
He's doing his thing.
Ba-boom, ba-boom, ba-doo-doo-doo.
He's got the beat.
I like the way Mr. Noodle dances.
Me too.
Mr. Noodle has a lot of heart and soul. What's that, Dorothy? Oh, okay. Dorothy wants to ask someone else. What does a doctor do with a stethoscope?
Dorothy, a doctor listens to your heartbeat with a stethoscope like this. Ba-boom, ba-boom, ba-boom.
And a doctor also uses it to listen to your lungs. Breathe deep, breathe deep, breathe deep. Sounds great.
Oh, thanks, everybody. Oh, and thank you, Dorothy. Oh, now Emma will listen to a baby's heartbeat. Hi, Sienna. Sienna, where's your heart? Oh, there it is. Okay. Oh, yeah. Wow. Boy, you have a really good heartbeat. Oh, thank you, baby. Boy, you gotta have heart. Oh, and now Elmo has a question for you. Yeah, you. How many stethoscopes are dancing in this conga line? Let's count them together and find out.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight!
Ho ho ho! Boy, eight stethoscopes dancing in the conga line! And one furry red monster. Oh, great counting, everybody.
Elmo has mail.
Oh, Elmo has email.
Elmo has mail.
Oh, look. Boy, the computer is playing doctor today.
Elmo has mail.
Oh, thank you, computer. Oh, it's email from Big Bird. Yay.
Hi, Elmo. I'm at the doctor's office, in the waiting room. I'm waiting to see the doctor.
My hip.
Hey, gee. I guess that's why they call this the waiting room. I like waiting because there's so many great toys in this waiting room. Like this doctor kit. Okay, Radar. Now, I'm Dr. Big Bird, and I'm going to examine you now. First, I'll look in your ear. Uh-huh. Fuzzy, just like they should be.
Big Bird, the doctor will see you now.
The doctor? Oh, the doctor. Gotta go. Bye, Elmo.
Oh, nice computer. Boy, that makes Elmo wonder. Who else goes to the doctor? The doctor. Who goes to the doctor and who doesn't? Let's find out. Oh, drawer, open up, please. Oh, come on, drawer. Like the doctor says, open up and say, ah! goats go to the doctor?
No.
But a doctor can have a birthday. Does a baby go to the doctor?
Yes.
A baby doctor?
No.
Not a baby who is a doctor. A doctor for babies and kids. A pediatrician.
Oh, a pediatrician. Do elephants go to the doctor?
Not like that. In a zoo, the animal doctor comes to an elephant.
Does a rock go to the doctor?
No, rocks don't go to doctors.
Unless it's my pet rock, Rocco. Say ah, Rocco.
It's a rock, Zoe. Ah, thanks, Troy. Elmo's friend Joe went to the doctor for a checkup, and he told Elmo all about it. You want to watch too, Troy? Okay.
Once a year, I go to the doctor for a checkup, just to make sure I'm healthy. My mom always comes with me.
Hello.
First, the nurse weighed me. Nurses help doctors.
Good.
Then she measured me.
Turn around.
I grew 2 inches last year. Then the doctor came in. She asked me to take off my shirt so she could examine me. First, she listened to my heart with a stethoscope. Then she listened to my lungs. Didn't hurt, but it was a little cold. Then she looked in my ears. That didn't hurt, but it tickled a little bit. She used something called a tongue depressor to look at my throat. The doctor said to stick up my tongue and say, ah.
Ah.
That didn't hurt either. Then the doctor examined the rest of me. My eyes. My stomach. My knees. None of that hurt either. She said I was very healthy. But I needed a shot so I would stay healthy. That hurt. But only for a minute. And then I got to pick out a sticker. And the exam was over. Mom said she was really proud of me. I was proud of me, too.
Aw, Elmo's so proud of Joe, too. Now, Elmo wants to learn more about doctors. How can Elmo find out more? Is TV sick? Does TV need a doctor?
No.
Oh, Elmo gets it. We can watch the doctor's channel. Turn yourself on, TV.
You're watching the doctor's channel. Just what the doctor ordered. And now, here's Doc Martin. Give it to us straight, Doc.
Hi, Doc Martin here with some doctorly advice. Hit it!
You're asking me, Doc, how do I stay strong? Just do the doctor all day long.
Do the doctor.
Do the doctor with me. Open your mouth and you won't feel blah. Stick out your tongue and just say ah. Ah, to the doctor. Show me your ears, show me your eyes. Do when the doctor keeps you healthy, gals and guys.
To the doctor.
Do the doctor with me. Rock around the dock. Show me your knees, show me your feet. Let me hear your heart go beat, beat.
Coming up next on the Doctor's Channel, Dr. No, followed by Dr. Yes.
know even
hi,
more.
Hi, Elmo.
Oh, hi, Big Bird.
Hi, I'm back from my checkup.
Oh, how did it go, Big Bird?
Well, the doctor says I'm fine and feathered.
Oh, good.
Bye, Elmo.
Bye, Big Bird. Elmo still wants to find out more about doctors. Oh, no. Sorry. Elmo meant doctors. Sorry. How can we find out more? Even more? Oh, excuse Elmo.
Want to talk to a doctor?
Oh, sure. What's up, Doc?
Well, for one thing, there are lots of different kinds of doctors.
Really?
Okay, doctors, the monster will see you now. Oh, yes, there they come.
Okay. Hey. I'm an eye doctor.
I am a foot doctor.
What kind of doctor are you?
He's not a doctor. He's a monkey.
Hey! I'd like a second opinion.
You're a monkey.
Uh-huh. He's my patient. I'm an animal doctor, a veterinarian.
Oh, yeah. Even animals have doctors.
That's right. Dogs, cats, giraffes, whales.
Whoa, look. Dorothy's imagining Elmo as a veterinarian underwater. Okay, time for your checkup. Open wide and say,
That goldfish has a whale of an imagination.
She sure does. Boy, doctors are great. Oh, Dorothy thinks so, too. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing that doctor song.
Ooh, may we sing along, too?
Sure. Doctors. Sing along. How do you take turns with a friend? Oh, good question, Dorothy. Let's ask Mr. Noodle. Mr. Noodle! Shane, be a pal and go up, please. That was very friendly. Pardon me, Shade. Oh, hi, Mr. Noodle. Hi. Dorothy has a question. How do you take turns with a friend, Mr. Noodle?
Yeah, Mr. Noodle. How do you take turns? Who's he calling? Who is it?
It's Mr. Noodle's sister, Miss Noodle.
Hi. Oh, I know her. Mr. Noodle.
She's your sister and your friend.
So how do you take turns with a friend? Wow, look at that. So take turns with a swing. No, no, not like that.
Take turns, Mr. Noodle and Miss Noodle. Yeah, take turns.
Mr. Noodle? Miss Noodle? That's not taking turns.
Come here, please.
Try again. Take turns on the swing. Just one person, then the other.
One person.
Now they got it.
Aww.
He cleaned it off for her. That's a good friend.
Very nothing.
No, wait. You okay, Miss Noodle?
Well, sharing is nice, but it's not taking turns. Miss Noodle, Mr. Noodle, come here again. Taking turns is when one person swings and the other person waits or pushes.
You got it now? Try again. Ooh, get the swing. Got it. Now take turns.
You can do it.
Miss Noodle.
Oh, that's it. Miss Noodle is taking a turn. Yay!
That's the way.
Okay,
Miss Noodle's turn. You push, Miss Noodle.
Yay!
Yeah.
You got it.
That's taking turns.
Oh, Miss Noodle again.
She got her own staff.
Boy, those noodles are real swingers. What's that, Dorothy? Oh, okay. Dorothy wants to ask someone else. How do you take turns with a friend?
Hi, Dorothy. This is how me and my friend Asan take turns holding my pet rabbit. It's my turn now. Now it's your turn, Asan.
Watch us take turns with these binoculars, Dorothy.
Look, a butterfly. Now it's my turn, Dorothy. Yeah, a butterfly.
Oh, thanks, everybody. Oh, and thanks, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask a baby. Wow, two babies. A baby and her baby friend. Oh, baby, how do you take turns with your friend? Oh, thank you, baby. Oh, and thank you too, baby. Oh, boy, those babies. Oh, and now...
My friend Rocco and I take turns. Watch. My turn, Rocco. Vroom, vroom.
Boy.
And now it's your turn, Rocco. Vroom, vroom. Oh, good one. Yeah. Bye, Elmo.
But Zoe, it's just a rock. Oh, boy. Where was Elmo? Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. And now Elmo has a question for you. Yeah, you. How many friends can fit on this boat? Let's count them and see. All aboard.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine.
Wow! Nine friends can fit on the boat. And one kangaroo. Don't rock the boat. One voyage. Hey, that's what Elmo calls a real friendship. Get it? Friendship. Oh, be a friend. Elmo wonders who else can be a friend. I'll draw. Everybody's so friendly today. Can draw be a friend? Can a birthday cake be a friend?
No.
But you can eat a birthday cake with your friends. Can a balloon be a friend?
No.
But you can give a balloon to a friend. Can a firefighter be a friend?
Yes.
Can a plant be a friend?
Sometimes, maybe.
Especially if it's stinky.
I'm a friend? Isn't that lovely?
Thank you, Joy. And now...
Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail.
Computer's friendly today,
Elmo
too.
Elmo has mail.
User friendly.
Elmo has mail.
Oh, boy. Elmo's got email from his friends, Snuffy and Big Bird.
Hi, Elmo.
Hi, Elmo. Bird and I are best friends.
Yeah.
We really care about each other.
We sure do. But do you know that sometimes friends can have arguments? Sure, Snuffy and I argue sometimes.
No, we don't, Bird. We never argue.
Oh, yes, we do, Snuffy.
No, we don't, Bird.
Yes, we do.
Bird, no, we don't
argue. Yes, we do.
No, Bird, we don't, Bird, no.
We're arguing right now.
We are?
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess you're right, Bird.
Yeah, and we're still friends.
Friends to the end, buddy of mine.
Yeah. Now, let's say goodbye to Elmo.
Okay, Bird, but you go first.
No, you go, old pal. Go ahead.
No, friend.
No,
I insist.
You.
No, you go first, Bird. Birdie,
Wait a minute. Mm-hmm. Wait a minute. We can say goodbye together.
Bird, that is just brilliant.
Yeah. Bye, Elmo!
Thanks, computer! Elmo's friend Rebecca has another good friend she likes to play with. And she told Elmo all about it.
My friend Nicole lives next door. And yesterday she came over to play. First, we made some jewelry with beads. We both love crafts. Then we looked at a book about space. We both love space exploration. Then we got hungry. So we went inside for a snack. We both wanted a banana, but there was only one left. So we shared it. We both love bananas. Then we went to the library with my mom to return the books. I carried the books, and my friend Nicole opened the door.
Here, catch!
Then, after the library, we played catch. Daniel came over and asked if he could play with us. We said sure. I had a great time playing with my friends.
Now, Elmo wants to learn even more about friends. How can we find out even more? Oh, yeah! We can watch the Friends channel on TV! Hey, TV, where are you going? That's not being very friendly. Come back, TV. Come on. Oh, now that's friendly. Put yourself on, TV. Thank you.
Welcome to the Friends channel.
This is the beginning of a beautiful friendship. And now the Friends channel presents the Friend Lady.
I love making friends. You want to make some new friends? Well, here's how you do it. Stick out your hand and say hello.
Hello.
You might meet someone just like you who's really great to know. Now mind you, I love the friends I've got. But making a new one hits the spot.
the baseball. How about you?
Wow, I don't believe this. I love baseball, too.
Me, too.
How are you?
What's new? Hey, how you doing?
When I meet someone new, I feel like mooing.
Moo!
Even if you're kind of shy, don't worry. It's okay. Come on, reach out and shake a hand and make a friend today.
What?
Reach out your hand and say hello. You might meet someone just like you who's really great to know.
It's wonderful to watch how friendships grow. When you stick out your hand and say, isn't life grand today? Stick out your hand and say hello.
Coming up next on the Friends Channel, two great buddy movies. For Me and My Pal, followed by Chum and Chummer.
Thanks, Stevie. Now, Elmo wants to learn even more about friends. But how?
Hey, Elmo.
Oh, hi, Zoe.
You want to talk to a friend?
Oh, yeah. Elmo can talk to his friend, Zoe.
No, I mean talk to Rocco.
But Zoe is Elmo's friend, not Rocco.
Why not?
Well, because it's a rock.
Oh, yeah, but Elmo, you can have all different kinds of friends, including rocks.
But Zoe, Elmo does...
Look!
What?
Look. Look, Rocco is imagining that Elmo is a rock.
Elmo doesn't believe this.
Hello,
Elmo. Will Elmo be Elmo Rock's friend? But Elmo Rock is a rock.
So, we can still be friends. Stick out your hand and say hello.
A rock singer!
You might meet someone just like you who's really great to know. It's wonderful to watch how friendships grow. When you stick out your hand and say, isn't life grand today? Stick out your hand and say hello.
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 Thanks, Rocco.
Oh, boy.
Doesn't Rocco have a great imagination?
It's a rock.
No.
Elmo loves friends. Oh, and so does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the friend song. And so does Dorothy's friend.
Oh, Rocco loves that song.
Good.
With the friend song. I love the friend song.
Then sing with Elmo. Friends. Everybody.
Friends.
Yes, friends.
places. Shade!
Mr. Noodle, how do you go places?
How do you go places?
Look, Mr. Noodle has a paddle.
Yeah.
A paddle to make you move.
Row, row, row your boat gently down the sea. Merry, 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 life is but a dream.
Oh, look, Mr. Noodle is in a canoe.
Yeah.
Yeah, a canoe. Uh-oh, Mr. Noodle.
Mr. Noodle's not on the water. We need
it's
water.
It's on the
water.
See, Mr. Noodle's not going any place.
We need some water.
You need water to go places in a canoe.
Water.
Yes, see?
Yeah,
it's very hard.
We need water.
Water.
We need water.
Try again.
Now what, Mr. Noodle? How's Mr. Noodle going to go places?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, Mr. Noodle's going to use his legs.
Yeah!
Walking is a great way to go places.
Yeah!
But Mr. Noodle's walking, but he's still not going anywhere. Mr. Noodle! Mr. Noodle! You're not going any place. Yeah, you have to move your feet and your legs.
You gotta go 1, 2, 3, 4.
That's it! Mr. Noodle! Now you're going places!
Yeah!
Walk, Mr. Noodle!
Yay!
Yay! Mr. Noodle, yay! Uh-oh!
Silly Mr. Noodle!
Oh, boy.
Oh, Dorothy wants to ask someone else. How do you go places?
Dorothy, I go on my tricycle.
Well, Dorothy, I drive my wheelchair.
Places on my skates. Watch, Dorothy.
Bye, Dorothy.
Oh, hi, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask a baby.
Yeah.
Oh. Hi, baby. How do you go places? Huh? Oh, like this? Okay. Oh, thank you, baby. And now, Elmo has a question for you about something else that takes you places.
Mm.
Oh, look, a car. Yeah, how many wheels are on a car? Let's count them and see.
1, 2, 3, 4.
4 wheels are on a car. Oh, Elmo forgot the steering wheel. Let's start again.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
5 wheels are on a car. Great counting. Wow, and a great wheelie. Now let's guess what kind of things can take you places and what things do not take you places. Take you places?
No!
Unless you're a bird. Bye, birdie! Do birthday cakes take you places?
No!
But you can ride your bike to a birthday party.
Yeah!
Do spaceships take you places?
Yes! To the moon!
Does Big Bird take you places?
No!
But he can if he has a wagon. To know more about things that take you places. How can Elmo find out more? Yeah, right. Well, Elmo can watch the trains, boats, planes, and things that take you places channel. Yeah.
the Trains, Boats, Planes, Things That Take You Places channel, also known as the Transportation Channel.
Transportation?
That's right, transportation.
Ah, transportation!
That's what trains and boats and planes and things that take you places are called. Transportation.
Transportation! Elmo loves that word.
The Transportation Channel. All transportation, all the time. Keep on truckin'. And now it's time for our feature presentation. Getting there is all the fun. Some traveling music, please.
Getting there is all the fun. One day, little Maggie McGillicuddy left her home at the corner of Peach and Vine. She walked to the bus stop. She got on a bus and took the bus to the train.
Oh, boy.
She took the train to the plane.
Ha ha!
The plane to the boat.
This is great.
The boat to the camel.
Is this fun or what?
She rode the camel to the hot air balloon.
Wowie kazowie.
And the hot air balloon to her home at the corner of Peach and Vine.
Whoopee.
The end.
Yay.
Coming up next on the Transportation Channel, My Mother the Car.
Bye, Jeannie. Oh, but Elmo wants to learn more about transportation. Where can Elmo learn more? Wow. Look at that.
Hey, you want to talk to a plane?
Yes.
Great. Well, first of all, I'm not just any old plane. Huh? I'm a jet plane.
Really?
Yeah, you see these wings?
Yeah?
Yeah, well, these help keep me up in the air.
Nice wings.
Thank you. And I have jet engines on my wings. You see them? And that's why I'm so fast. Yeah, I'm faster than a car, than a train, or a boat.
Ah.
Yeah, watch this.
Okay. Ooh, I'm fast, too. A jet plane.
Well, of course you're not, but you're a very fast monster.
Oh, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, well, what are those? Are those wheels?
Oh, yeah, these are my wheels. Yeah, I use them for taking off and for landing. Yeah, but mostly I fly up in the sky.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
cool.
And can I tell you a secret?
Yeah.
And you too. Listen to this. I can't fly alone. No, I need someone to help me fly. A pilot.
Yeah. Elmo knows about an airplane pilot. Maybe someday Elmo will be an airplane pilot.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no! Dorothy's imagining Elmo as an airplane pilot, flying a plane. Wow. This is your pilot, Captain Elmo. Please fasten your seatbelts.
Trains need someone to help them go, too. A train engineer.
Chugga-chugga-chugga-chugga. Woo-woo! How is your day? Later, little Joe.
Boats also need someone to help them go.
Oh, hello, fishies. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream.
Yep. all transportation needs someone to help it go.
Transportation!
And here I go.
Bye. Wow. Elmo loves planes. Elmo's friend Ernie loves planes, too. So, Elmo made a video with this video camera right here of Ernie pretending to be a plane. It's called Ernie pretending to be a plane. By Elmo. Yeah. Here comes. Oh, thank you, TV. And that's Ernie pretending to be an airplane. Yeah. Woo, woo, woo. Thank you, TV. Elmo really likes planes and trains and cars and all kinds of transportation. Oh, Dorothy likes transportation, too. That's why Dorothy wants to sing the transportation song. Right, Dorothy? Here we go. Transportation, transportation, transportation. Sing it loud if you want to. Transportation, transportation, transportation. In a one-horse open sleigh. Oh, this is another type of transportation. Get in, Percy.
Okay.
Say bye, Dorothy. Get in, Percy.
Oh.
The nonprofit educational organization behind Sesame Street and so much more. Learn more at sesameworkshop.org.
Do, 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 do.